Representative for the Brazilian Blowout Nigeria. Today I'm going to be talking to you about how you make your money from selling the brand and the products. If you're watching this video, it's because you're a stylist and you're interested in what we're doing. Now I'm going to start with how you make your money before we get into the basics of the products and the questions you're going to have to answer from your clients. First, the Brazilian Blowout comes in a salon combo which goes for 200,000 naira. In this salon combo, you have the treatment and you have the aftercare maintenance treatment. This is supposed to carry a minimum of 36 clients if you use it, but if you use it properly, it should take about 48 clients for the mini combo. For 200,000 and with a minimum charge of, say, 15 to 20,000 for per service, you will make nothing less than 900,000. Then if you're going for the large pack, which sells for about 350,000 naira, that will give you a minimum of 120 uses. But if you have the best use, if you make the best out of it, you're going to get at least 136 uses. And for 350,000, you're making at least 2.1 million. This mathematics may seem a bit outrageous, but it is achievable because with the Brazilian Blowout products, less is more. Now, having said that, I'm going to answer some of the questions that are likely to come up. The best candidate for the Brazilian Blowout is anyone, like I say, who has hair. So it means for the sister with the natural hair, for someone who has a perm, for someone who has processed her hair, for someone whose hair is damaged, and for those of us that wear extensions, like the fusion hair extension, you can actually have the Brazilian Blowout with the extensions on. So basically, anyone can have the Brazilian Blowout. Now, when it comes to the look, it depends majorly on your hair texture. For the natural hair sister, you're going to have a smooth, manageable hair, and your hair is going to have the bounce and shine that comes with good and healthy hair. For those with processed hair, your hair is practically going to be your weave-on. Let me use the word good hair weave-on. Brazilian Blowout works perfectly on color. So if you've done any kind of color treatment on your hair, the Brazilian Blowout does not only repair the frizz, but it actually locks your hair in the protein bubble, which is what it's made of. The Brazilian Blowout is made of amino acid. So it protects your hair while carrying the color. So to that I say yes, it is not just possible, but it's also good for the health of your hair. This is almost like, okay, let me go straight to this. point. For the Brazilian blowout, the result you get is based on your hair texture. I think I mentioned that earlier. If your hair has been previously processed through retouching or texturizing, your result is going to be very beautiful. Your hair is going to come in single strands and it's going to fall in place. Now, the texture you're going to get is that smooth, lovely, silky hair finish. But for the person with the Brazilian and with the natural hair, you're going to have straight looking hair, meaning that at a closer look, you're going to still see texture. The advantage of the Brazilian blowout is there is no damage to your hair before and after the treatment. Your hair returns to its original state at the end of your treatment. So for the person with the straight with the natural hair, your hair is going to be smooth and frizz-free. Now let me quickly add this. If your hair is natural and you do not want to lose the curl, you can actually stop at a certain stage, which leaves your hair, your curls looser, so you won't have our very tight afro. You're going to have more like a jerry kind of afro. So it's a win-win situation if you do not want to straighten it out at the end. Technically, the BB is supposed to last for a period of 12 weeks, that's 3 months. But this also depends on your lifestyle. If you're a client who is busy, who works out, yeah, with the maintenance product, it should last for 3 months. But if you have more of a laid-back life and the AC in-out kind of job, it can take you for up to 4 months if you use with the maintenance product and the maintenance regime. Now, that I would say a big yes to. The Brazilian blowout works perfectly on relaxed hair, like I mentioned before. This being that your hair has already been straightened. So the Brazilian blowout just protects those strands that are already open and gives it that finished look. So for the period of 3 months, your hair is going to have that straight, silky look and also the bounce. So can it be applied on texturized, relaxed, colored hair? The answer is yes. Now, when it comes to volume, your hair will not lose volume. And in this sense, what we mean is, if your hair naturally is full, your hair will remain full. The only thing you're going to lose is the frizz. So your hair is going to be smooth all the way. It won't have the frizz that comes with having an afro hair. But for people with scanty hair, we teach the stylists how to manage their hair so they don't end up having very light hair. Because for someone with very scanty hair, if you go all the way down to the root, the hair is going to be light and the strands are going to be in units. So the client may not appreciate it, but if it's for someone with normal to full hair, definitely they would still love their blowout. So does it make you lose volume? No. Or can you create volume for someone with scanty hair? The answer is yes. For color, yes, it is possible for you to wear color the same day as you've had a BB. But if you've had a BB, you must wait for 2 weeks before you have a color done. But I always advise that people wait for 24 hours after having a color to have their BB. But it is possible to have the color and the Brazilian blowout the same day. Now, for the maintenance, this is very key for the Brazilian blowout treatment. Every stylist should have their client visit at least 2 weeks after the treatment. meaning that from 2 weeks after they've had this treatment, they're supposed to have a wash where they use the antifreeze collection. Now, with the client who's got scanty hair, you need to follow up with the volumizer collection, where this helps maintain the integrity of the blowout. And when you're done with this treatment, you're supposed to send the client home with either the dry oil, the spray and shine, the sculpt wax, or the clay wax. These products are formulated basically to maintain the lifespan of the Brazilian blowout. I dare say that if you use another product, your blowout may not last for up to a month. But with this product, you have the insurance that it's going to carry you for 3 to 4 months.
Right, Brazilian blowout has been in the market for over 5 years. It's been formulated and reformulated over the years, and everybody's worried about the formaldehyde question. Now, there is no formaldehyde in the Brazilian blowout product at all, and if used as instructed, you should have no problems with it at all. The only thing I would say that you shouldn't do is if your client or yourself is pregnant or breastfeeding, and the only reason why we say don't do that because it hasn't been tested for that, so we don't know what the result is. But theoretically, it's all fine. Did I answer your questions?
That's I think she asked 3 questions.
What was the
what
other
was
one?
The last one?
The genetic effect.
She asked about that.
I don't know. I'm not a chemist. I'm a hairdresser.
Why are you asking me? Okay, I'm about to use the product.
Right.
I'm transitioning. You just mentioned something.
Oh, you're transitioning from relaxer to natural.
Yes.
Okay, fine.
So if I'm to use the product.
Yes.
And okay, you mentioned something about if I am pregnant or breastfeeding.
Yeah.
So if I use it now and I get pregnant or something.
No, if you get pregnant, that's a different story.
But you know that you're not right. I should think it's okay. But you know when you have a product and you're testing and you're continuously testing? So they're testing. And they have got no results at the moment, so I can't say to you it's safe to use if you're pregnant. It probably is. Until the test results come in, I can't say. So what they tell us to tell you is that if you're pregnant or breastfeeding, don't do it. If you're transitioning, there is a technique to do it, to transition. This is an amazing product to transition with. I've done many ladies who are transitioning without any problem. Okay?
Thank you.
Let's take off. So we'll start with the Brazilian blowout. First thing you're going to do when you do Brazilian blowout is to clean the hair. The hair has to be really, really clean. And what you do to clean the hair, you use the shampoo, please. You use the anti-residue shampoo. Now, the difference between this shampoo and a normal shampoo is it's designed to clean the hair and keep it in readiness for the next step of the Brazilian blow dry. Can you use another shampoo? Yes, you can use another shampoo. But will it be as effective? No. Because everything in the line is designed to work with each other. It's synergetic. So if you replace any part of the step with something else, it will work, but it won't be as good, and you won't be able to guarantee the effects to last as long as it should do. Okay? It's really clear. So whenever you're using this product, use the whole system. So for this length of hair, I've got half an ounce of the Prism Blur solution. Okay? Right. First thing to do is divide the hair. So you go from front to back. Now the reason for sectioning the hair like this is for control, okay? Now, it's important that when you're working with the hair is damp, because the water acts as a catalyst to help spread the product throughout the hair. Understood?
Yeah.
If you don't understand, please let me know. Right, so first thing you do, I think the best thing to do is so that you can see. Now, the important thing to remember is to use enough product, but not too much. Okay? When you use too much product, it creates vapor and it's a waste. Because the hair can only use a certain amount. Once it's finished, the rest of the products on the hair is just a waste. Okay? Now, Brazilian Blowout has this brush, which is really good. So you apply with a brush and you comb through with it. So you take a small section. And you dip it in the product. Can you see how much I've got on the brush?
Yeah.
You don't need much. You apply it to the roots, then you mid length and ends, and then you comb through. And as you see, I'm wearing gloves. You must always wear gloves. Take small sections. I like to comb the hair through for control. And then you comb through. Now, if you find that the hair is drying out as you do it, take a water spray and you lightly dust the hair. Don't get it soaking wet, just damp. So you continue. The process in this way. Now I'm not worried about this underneath section because the product's on here. So when I comb it through, it will spread it firm. But you make sure that your section is not too thick. Okay? And as you can see, I'm using the comb to work the product through to the ends of the hair. Is there any questions out there so far? No? Are you okay? So when you apply the product, it shouldn't take too long. So you can see I'm not using too much product, okay? So have you done this before?
I'm a stylist.
Oh, you're not a stylist. Has anybody here done the Brazilian blowout before? Using too much product, okay? So have you done this before?
I'm a stylist.
Oh, you're not a stylist. Has anybody here done the Brazilian blowout before? No, okay. So please take note the amount of product that I'm using on the hair. You don't need to absolutely cake it on, okay?
I want to know, are the components of this product all natural?
No.
You have chemicals in it?
Right, let's be clear. Everybody possesses to have these natural products, plant extracts and all the rest of it. Now, what happens is when those products are developed, what they do is they find out what those ingredients are, then they manufacture them and use them. Because it's cheaper to manufacture those ingredients than it is to extract the plant. Because you imagine you have to grow the plants, you have to feed the plant and all that sort of stuff, and then extract it. And then what you extract from that plant is just a small amount. So it's not cost effective. So what they do is find out what the actual active ingredients that they want and need, and then they manufacture it. So no, it's not natural. Everybody professes these natural. There's very few products on the market that you've got that are totally organic and natural. Okay?
Okay, well, still on that, she raised a concern. If, after the Brazilian blowout, maybe you want to wear a protective weave, will it affect the duration you can carry the Brazilian blowout?
No, but the Brazilian blow dry relies on you wearing it curly if you want to, or you blow drying it straight. It will stay straight. What reduces the time of the Brazilian, what reduces the life of the Brazilian blow dry is what you do after. Like if you use a strong shampoo, if you go swimming, if you put products that will strip the product out of the hair, a weave won't do that, so you should be okay.
And you can braid your hair in between?
Sure. Yes, you can.
Anyone else has a question? Okay.
So I want to find out, for those carrying dreadlocks, what's the process of having to use this? Can this product work for me at all?
Right, this is no good for dreadlocks. If you've got dreadlocks, dreadlocks is matted hair. And no.
If you've got locks, then this is no good to you.
Oh, it's very hot in here today. Thank you. Right.
Who has a question?
Okay, right, so I've applied the product. Can you see? It was quick, it was easy, no messing around. You apply the product, you make sure you cover every strand of hair from root to end. That's very, very important. Now, after you've blow-dried the product, after you've applied the product, you have to blow dry the hair and you use a bristle brush. A boar's bristle brush. The reason why we say you use that is boar's bristle helps to smooth the cuticle and create shine.
Now, this product works on smoothing the cuticle and creating shine. If you use the brushes with a metal core, they overheat and then you create this vapor coming off the hair. And it doesn't close the cuticle as efficiently as a boar's bristle brush. So that, to get the best result, that's what you use. You can either use a round brush or a... a grooming brush, but they're both boar's bristle. Okay? Any questions? No?
About the dread.
Now, oh,
right. She's wearing a natural dread.
Yeah, but what you've got to understand is dreads, when you look at a dread, it's lots of hair all tangled and matted together, yes?
Yes, I understand. But then,
yes.
I think you can do Brazilian blowout and then wear the other kind of dread, not the natural one, you know, the one that they actually fix.
Oh, right.
And you can actually carry
it. So that's an extension, yes?
Yeah.
Yes. So you can, right. Me personally, I don't see why you're going to spend your time and money and have this procedure and then put extensions on it. What's the point? If you're going to put your extensions on and then you're going to leave some of your hair out, then the hair that you're going to leave out, then you do the Brazilian blowout on that hair. But what's the point of this service? Is time consuming, so it means it costs money, plus the product. So why are you going to spend that money and then cover it?
Well, it's more like retouching and also doing the same thing. Allows you to grow your hair.
Yeah, but then I would say grow your hair with your extensions. Once you've grown your hair and you're ready, goes right, now I want to wear my hair, then do it. Okay? Because it's a big investment. It's great and your hair will look fantastic. And I don't understand why you would do this and then go and put extensions in. It's, to my mind, it's a little bit unusual.
I have a question.
Yes.
What's the difference between these two brush?
Right. Right, the only difference between these two, I've been asked, what's the difference between these two brushes? The only difference, this one has these nylon filaments which help to massage the scalp and detangle the hair. This is just a plain boar's bristle, so they're both usable. If this is a boar's bristle brush, then it's fine. Okay?
It's good for the blow dry.
Yeah. Oh. Sweet, man. Right. I did it on this slide, yeah, so. This water brush.
So when you blow dry, you don't put the dryer on the brush. Because when you put the dryer on the brush, this gets hotter, then this gets hotter, and then you create fumes. Okay? So the distance between the brush and the dryer should be about that. Okay? So
the trick is to grab the hair, put your head back slightly, and stretch the hair. And when you stretch the hair, put a little heat to straighten and dry the roots. The roots of the hair must be dry, otherwise when you go to flat iron it, it's gonna burn, okay? So you stretch the hair. Is there anybody that can't see what I'm doing? You can all see, okay. Don't put the dryer on the brush.
Because when you put the dryer on the brush, this gets hotter, then this gets hotter, and then you create fumes, okay? So the distance between the brush and the dryer should be about that, okay? Because what we're trying to do is that in preparation for flat ironing.
Oh, you're killing us.
anybody got any more questions? Okay, so I'm slowly going through the hair, section by section, making sure that the hair at the root is nice and dry, and I'm using my bristle brush and heat with a bit of tension to stretch the hair out in preparation. What's the question?
I said if one is actually carrying a pinned hair, is it possible to achieve the results of this Brazilian blowout?
When you say perm, do you mean like a curly perm?
Relaxer, yes. Yes, you do. When I come to the flat iron, I'll explain the difference between the two. But you have to be careful. You don't treat it the same as natural hair. The application is the same. The blow drying is the same. But when we come to do the flat iron, it's different.
Second question, please.
Yes.
If after achieving this, and I decide to tint my hair, to color the hair, what will happen to the hair texture?
When it comes to colour, what happens is you can colour and do this procedure on the very same day. If you don't do it on the same day, then you have to wait for 14 days and then do your colour. But if you're going to bleach or something like that with a high volume peroxide, I would suggest that you do that first and then do this on the same day, or wait 14 days after you've done the colour and then do this procedure.
Okay. That will thwart the growth of the hair.
That will?
Won't thwart the growth of the hair.
No, it won't. Like, this doesn't affect the growth of your hair. Your hair grows. As long as you're healthy and you're eating well, your hair will grow. And you have nothing wrong with it.
More questions?
Say again?
Is it the maiden entry of the product into the Nigerian market?
In my experience, you'll always find somebody who's gone abroad and brought it into the market. I know there's a few people who have tried it, but this is kind of like the official first time. This is the first time a representative to represent Brazilian Blowout has come, as far as I know. So this is kind of like the first official steps into bringing it into the market. And I will be coming back time and time again, doing workshops and answering questions, and make sure that you use the product correctly to get the best results.
Okay. My question goes, 5 years down the line, you are in business. I would like to know from the UK, which certification by way of help?
No, right. Today is just an introduction to you, to show you what the product can do. Then what will happen is we'll do workshops. Now, when we do workshops, that means we'll show you and you will do it. Now, once you've done it, then you'll be submitted. Then you'll get a certificate saying that you have done a Brazilian blowout workshop.
No, not that certification. There's something I'm about to ask. My question is for on safety and health.
Right.
To the human, to the customers, as it is. 5 years into your business, you are going international. In fact, you are in Africa now. Which agency from the UK from the UK health institution has given endorsement?
To be honest with you, I can't answer that question because, to be honest with you, I don't know.
Okay.
And the business side of it, but it's a good question, and I will go back and I will ask it and find out. Okay.
Right, any questions so far? No? Really? Yes. Mike?
One more question.
It's a question over here.
You raise your hand so I can see you. Okay.
Professor, with what you've done so far,
you can see as the fan gets it, it just flows really soft and controllable. So this is the result, relaxer, yes? This is how you'll get it straight and you'll be happy with that. So now, what we're going to do from here, what's going to happen is, this has to be rinsed. You have to rinse all the residue of the product from the hair. And then after you rinse that from the hair, then we put on the mask. Now the hair mask, what we will do, someone rinse this for me please. Does anybody want to try and finish before we get a rinse now? Anybody?
Yeah.
Welcome. I know I'm trying to do this as quickly as I can.
Thank you. please, especially those of us that have salons, those of us that have salons, I think we should go forward and feel the texture of the hair. Probably you should go and feel the hair texture. You have a salon, right? Yes. Please.
Once we got rid of that, then we put the hair mask on and you apply it. Now the hair mask is, it's designed to detangle the hair, make the hair feel soft, promote shine. It's got thermal protection in it, so it's really, really important that you use this. And remember, you can use this as your general purpose treatment. So, I'm just working it into the hair. Okay, can you step up for me, please? Right, if I turn her head around, can you see these straight ends here? That tells me that's where relaxer was. Okay? And if you can look closely, you can see her hair has got loads of little curls, which is kind of cute. So if you've used the right product, you can induce those curls and the way it's as a loose curl. But as soon as we get a dry and a brush on this, this will go really straight, really easy, and it will stay straight until you wet the hair again. So this just needs to be on the hair for 2 to 3 minutes. Can you see the curls? Yes? So you know, like when you texturize hair, you get a beautiful curl. The first time you texturize the hair. That's what this is. Now, if you keep on doing this every 3 months, this curl will stay uniform. It won't get straighter and straighter and straighter. It will stay like this. It may get a little bit looser, but it won't go straight. So now she's got the option to wear it like this, or she can dry and have a nice textured afro, or we can blow dry it straight. Any questions? But now you can see what it does with relaxed hair. Okay? It's straight and it stays straight. See, that's relaxing flat ironing. Okay? It's flow dry, it's soft, and it looks like it's been relaxed, yes? It's got a nice finish. Now I'm going to finish off with the dry oil. The dry oil looks a bit like a serum and acts a bit like a serum, but it is an actual oil. And the great thing about it is it doesn't weigh the hair down.
Okay, so everybody, we have before and we have after. Can you move around so they can see? Now remember,
I didn't flat iron his hair. All I did was blow dry, and then put some dry oil in at the end, and we've got a nice straight blonde, which works really, really well. Any questions? No questions? Any questions, guys? Wanna feel from the top? Feels nice.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Still shiny. It's going to stay that way. Okay?
It's not
going to
shrink off because you know your humidity here.
It
works really well.
So, this is the Brazilian blowout. Remember, do not replace any of the products within the line. It's important that you use the whole entire line. Okay? And that's all I've done. Blow dry it. It's nice and silky. Thank you very much. Any questions on the Brazilian blowout? No? Right. Thank you very much. So before I go, what I would like to do is go to some of the Revlon. Thank you. So what they'll do, someone will finish off her hair later. She's not going to be like that forever and ever and ever. They'll finish off later. So, before you go today, and that's been quite a long morning, so I'm going to quickly go through the Revlon colours. If I was to choose, I would prefer to use a steep. But I do use a dry, and I get very good results. So, it's just whichever you prefer. But the most important thing is the product you put on the hair. No, you know, we need, right, olaplex, you have to use one and two.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, then once you've done that, then you do your shampoo, then you do your mops. Okay, you guys want that?
When you wash up the number one, you apply number two.
No, you put the number two on top of the number one.
Number
one. Then yes. Like, if you read the instructions, it says 7 minutes. Then 7 minutes. But I like to leave it longer because the longer you leave it, the more it makes the hair stronger. So if you can leave it, if you're in a hurry, 7 minutes is better than nothing. Okay? 7 minutes will do something and the hair will feel a difference. But if you leave it 15, that's 30 minutes. Then you do your shampoo and you do your steam treatment. The difference in the hair. If you're not sure, get a client and do half of the olaplex and half of that. And you'll notice a difference. You really will. I finally convinced a client to let me use the olaplex. She's one of these ladies, no, I'm happy with what I have. And I said, please, I beg you, let me, I'm not going to charge you, just let me do it. And when I did it, afterwards she said, oh my gosh, my hair. I don't know what it is, but my hair just feels better. What can I tell you? So it really works on the hair. It's got no cosmetic effect. It goes into the hair, into the cuticle, and finds the disulfide bonds and links them together, which in turn makes the hair stronger.
So what's happening
after applying the number one? Do your shampoo and all that kind of stuff as normal. You must do that. Okay? And if you do that, I guarantee, especially when you're ladies with long hair, because you know the long hair, and you literally comb it, there's hair coming out, and you're blowing and you're going, oh gosh, I have this hair left by the time I finish this.
I think it's better if we can ask the question to the hearing of everyone, so we can also learn.
Right, so is anybody here got any more questions?
Any more questions?
No? Well, then thank you very much, everybody. I think I've gone through all the products. I hope that's introduced you to our products that will be available to you soon, so you can do a better service to your salons and your clients. Please look out for us coming back and for our workshops, which will be very interesting to you because you'll be able to come and actually use the products yourself, which is the best way to do it. So thank you very much for your time. I hope you've learned something.
and I look forward to seeing you next time.
Thank you so very much. Round of applause. Please put your hands together for him.
Thank you for staying on through, and I hope you learned a lot. This is the next big money. Believe it or not, you're going to be seeing a lot of us here on platforms that you will be asking yourself, is it just hair business? It depends on how serious you take what we've done today. About sales and distribution, I addressed it earlier. So for the product, the treatment product, you only get it from a stylist or a salon that is certified. After this program, we have already mentioned for Papaibom State, M Strand is the one handling the treatment for Papaibom State. But if you want to also register with this brand, speak to M Strand. She is offering the service, but she is not tied, her salon is not just tied to it. If you have any questions concerning it, you ask her, she will register you. The reason why we're doing the registration is so we can control the spread, so it doesn't end up entering the wrong hands. You may have the right products, but if you use them wrongly, you're going to get very wrong results. So the reason why M Strands is the person you meet is so she will put you through for Papaibom State. And for those of you in River State, we have Jocks Exclusive. She's also here, and I think her contact is here as well. If you want more information on how you're going to use the product and how you're going to run it, please speak with Jocks Exclusive. She is the one. For Jocks Exclusive is the one that will be handling any questions and further product dissemination in River State. Then for people from Abuja, M Strand is also handling for Abuja. So it is not just where do I buy the product, but it's knowing that it's in the hands of the right people. So clients, stylists, if we do this the right way, we'll definitely have good results. I hope I've answered that question.
Price.
I just told you that the price is not a product you walk into a shop and buy. So you need to go to these places I've mentioned. Yes, ma'am.
A thousand miles away from you, I'll prove.